Hello everybody, my name is Kujana Kuladinti from Hamburg University of Technology. EPIC is all about collaboration among students and supervisors from academia and industry, more importantly from different cultures. There is no one size fits all. Here both universities and companies have different traditions and roles. So in this intellectual output, O6, we try to create a framework for setting up the collaborations for student projects. We have followed some guidelines to finalize our project themes and then advertise them among students. Every year in September, all partner universities decide what are the themes. Here you see several themes. We had for 2019 and 2020, we had only one big theme called Sustainable Development Project. We also involved in contacting industrial partners to inquire about their interest in subtopics for each theme. For example, autonomous vehicles theme in 2019, we had four subtopics. The first three subtopics are for students with a technical background, and the last subtopic is advertised for business students. Then students are allowed to apply for different themes, and EPIC partners get together to make the final decision on selecting students and forming student groups. The most challenging part was forming student groups. For example, student projects can be a joint project where the students work under the same learning objectives, report the results together. Or it can be more loosely coupled projects where different projects with different learning objectives. Therefore, we propose some guidelines and also models to reflect the collaboration among students and supervisors. Forming student groups require considering these requirements. Different students from different universities meet. They have a different focus. Could be on technical or could be on business aspects. They deal with different ECTS requirements. Local regulations are completely different. For example, thesis submission can be individual, joint, or no submission at all. In addition to these heterogeneous requirements, we also deal with different types of theses with the different duration of completion times. Here are our proposed models describing how students from different universities interact with each other. Let's look at two extreme cases. Model 1 is a very simple collaboration where students work jointly at the beginning and at the end. And Model 4 shows a complicated collaboration where students collaborate throughout the project and they also submit joint thesis reports. Model 2 and 3 come in between these two extreme cases. In case if we see very different ECTS requirements, durations, different goals, model 1 fits well, but this is really not the preferable model for a joint collaboration. The other three models work well with the same duration, more or less the same ECTS requirements and same focus. Most EPIC projects were based on Model 3, where students had joint work throughout the project but submitted an independent thesis for grading done by the local university. In EPIC, we promoted problem-based learning. The joint work happened during problem analysis and the definition of project goals, and then some of the tasks were done with virtual physical collaboration later. End of the physical meeting in February, we had an equal understanding of the problem and project objectives. For example, this is how we see our project models for autonomous vehicle for each subtopic. The first subgroup focus on implementation aspects and the other group focused on simulation analysis. This ends the short summary of what we have done in the 6th intellectual output of EPIC project. Thank you for your time.